katuninungan, bunga ni
Villa Fuerte.
Magbang Pasko po sa inyo,
Fuente Belia.
Bagong taong masagana, bagong buhay.
Alfilor. Once political rivals, now allies. Camarines Sur is divided into 5 districts, each having a political clan staking claim as their bailiwicks. There's the Andayas in the 1st district, the Arroyos in the 2nd, Villafuertes in the 3rd, Fuente Bellas in the 4th, and the Alfilors in the 5th district. But now, the lines have been blurred. An alliance was formed between families that have been against each other during elections for decades. There's Luis Villafuerte, current patriarch of his family, who is running for a congressional seat in the 3rd district. He has now thrown his support for Tigaon Mayor Arnie Fuentebelia, who is up against Villafuerte's own estranged grandson, re-electionist Governor Migs Villafuerte. It's not every day a Villafuerte supports a Fuentebelia given their long political history. There has been several matchups over the years between the two families. Ever since the Villafuertes entered politics in 1928. The Fuentebellas, meanwhile, are considered the longest-running political dynasty in the country with over 100 years in elected posts. For Scion Arnie Fuentebelia, he hopes that voters look beyond his last name and into his own track record come election day.
Di ko po kasi iniisip eh. Ang mas iniisip natin is the legacy na pwede mong iiwan kung ikaw ay nakapagsilbi sa bayan mo.
Fuentebelia's running mate is lawyer Pichi Alfilor, who is gunning for the vice gubernatorial seat. She too is from a powerful political family in CamSur, the Alfilors, who entered the scene in 1938. Even the Fuentebelias and Alfilors had their fair share of fierce rivalries over the years. But all of that, Alfilor says, is behind them.
Moving forward kami, looking towards the future, totoo medyo masalimuot yung proseso. Para magkaisa yung mga pamilya. Pero talagang pag ang pinag-usapan na ay ang probinsya, kung paano natin masasaayos ito, naibababa namin lahat ng nangyari nung nakaraan.
Yeah, and it's, ano eh.
For Fuentebelia, it's high time they put aside differences to solve long-running problems like poverty in the province. He criticizes Migs Villafuerte for not installing officials in key departments in the local government.
We are the 3rd in the poorest sa buong Pilipinas because yun na nga sinasabi natin. Bakit? Ano bang kabuhayan natin dito sa Camarines Sur? Agrikultura. Bakit wala tayong provincial agriculturist?
The younger Villafuerte declined an interview with ABS-CBN for this story. But his own running mate, re-electionist Vice Governor Ato Peña, who is seeking his 3rd term, defends their handling of CamSur affairs.
There may not be permanent employees or officials appointed to that position, but there are people assigned to address the problem. So hindi naman totally pinapabayaan talaga yan.
Peña is confident that both he and Migs Villafuerte will be re-elected even against the alliance of prominent families.
Hindi kami threatened eh, kasi alam namin ang ginagawa namin. We're doing our job as elected officials ng province. And we're very confident that we have the support of the people. Pero we're not claiming the perfect ang ginagawa namin. But we're very sincere in trying to discharge our functions.
For political scientist Agapito Prima Jr., alliances in Camarines Sur bear little weight. He says problems in the province like poverty remain unresolved because ballots carry the same old names.
Ang sabi ko nga, ang mga Bicolano, especially sa CamSur, hindi mahihirapang pumili. Kasi kung sa isang examination, sa multiple choice, ang choices ay iyon at iyon. Naiiba lang ng, ano, ng posisyon.
Come election day, voters in Camarines Sur will face the same dilemma. Who to choose among familiar names who all promise to solve familiar problems. For Campaña Serie, Jeff Canoy, ABS-CBN News.